Richardson, Joe Wilkinson, Chris Addison, Katherine Ryan, David O'Doherty, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
And welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, hypothermia is a state in which the core temperature of the body falls below 35 degrees? People who die from it include mountaineers and, during a cold snap, viewers of regular Countdown. A Victorian slang term for a vagina was a crinkle crankum. I find it fascinating. I love looking up things like that. And to obnunciate is to announce bad news, as used in the sentence, the shopkeeper obnunciated, I'm sorry, Rachel, but we only have that particular dress in a child size.
Saves on VAT, you'd know all about that, Jimmy.
Saves on VAT. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Jon Richardson. Jon recently became a father. Jon's got OCD, so the conception took a while, as soon as he turned his wife on, he had to go back and make sure he turned her off again. And Jon's teammate, Chris Addison. I'm not saying Chris Addison has weirdly long limbs, but I'm not sure whether to laugh at him or trap him under a glass and put him outside. Up against them this evening is special guest team captain Joe Wilkinson. Joe lives in Brighton. He fits right in because if there's one thing the residents of Brighton love, it's a hairy bum. And joining Joe tonight is Katherine Ryan. Katherine Ryan is Canadian. If you don't know much about Canada, just imagine America is Waitrose, then Canada is a really boring country just to the north of Waitrose. Katherine, you often tweet about celebrities. If you could go on holiday with any celebrity, who would it be?
Oh, my gosh, I'd probably go on holiday with you.
Excellent choice. Why me?
I mean, I think you're super fun, and I know you live a lavish lifestyle, and, like, I think you need a best friend. And we have...
You know I'm a real boy.
I could watch you be mean to people. I would love that. In different countries. And we would stay in, like, the best hotels. And no one would ever rob us, Kardashian style.
You're turning into Sean Connery.
Bit of advice, don't go on holiday, Rich and Judy.
What happened? What happened?
All they do is read books and screw.
Joe, how do you unwind at the end of a hard day?
Oh, how do I unwind? What I like to do is I like to run a hot bath, put some bubbles in it, sprinkle some petals in there, pour myself a nice glass of wine, then I slide in the bath and I wait for whosoever house I've just broken into.
John, here's a question for you. What's currently on your to-do list?
I'm currently heading up an investigation into why men have stopped wearing socks. At what point somebody decided it was fine, but it really isn't fine. The fungicide. I got bullied for having half-mast trousers at school. I wore them deliberately to show off a quite splendid sock range. These kids now...
So you had trousers that were too short for you? Chris, in the thick of it, you did quite a lot of creative swearing.
Yes.
Do you do any of that in real life? Have you got any good...
Fuck yes.
Does a swear an inanimate object?
Oh, yeah.
You know that? I called a chair a fuckwad.
Nobody else was around. There was nobody that I was addressing. I stubbed my toe and called it a fuckwit. I've called my cat a little asshole. That's when you know it's slightly out of control.
How do you get around, like, you've got kids?
Yeah.
Do you swear in front of them or do you use creative?
I try to avoid swearing in front of them because I don't want them to guess what the Wi-Fi password is.
You gotta swear as much as you can in front of your kids because you're not cool to them and therefore swearing's not cool.
Oh, that's good.
So I know that my daughter's never gonna swear, like bang a load of guys in the garden.
Or if she does, she won't call it bang. That's all. She'll say, make love to a load of guys in the garden.
And that's the kind of loser I want.
Yeah.
Okay, Chris, have you got a mascot?
Yeah.
What did you bring?
I brought this crocheted dissected rat.
What?
My wife made me for my last birthday. She said, I've got exactly what you will want for your birthday. And she sat up at nights crocheting me a dissected rat.
Are you sort of mid-divorce now?
Because we've been together about 18 years, so you run out of ideas after about 9. And
most people go with, like, bondage.
That was years 10 through 13, right? So we pushed through that.
What do you get her?
What do I get her? I get her an Amazon voucher. Between £25 and £50, depending on how the year's been.
Do you know, the worst thing about that is I could just see John's little head going, oh, that's a good idea. Katherine, have you got a mascot?
I have a mascot.
What's your mascot?
I've been in show business 10 years now.
Have you?
Yeah.
Where are all these accents coming from this evening?
10 years in show business. And so I wore shoulder pads, that's number one.
2-0 okay. On shoulder pads, isn't
it? Yeah, I wear as well, yeah.
How many years have you been in show business?
I don't think you could call what Joe does show business. The man that what actually happened is the man that died in that suit. Had shoulder pads for reasons of his own.
To be fair, he put up a hell of a fight.
So my mascot, after 10 years in show business, I feel like it's time for me to start being an asshole, or like at least having a celebrity quirk. Because, like, Christian Bale goes against superstitions. He'll purposely pour out salt, I read, and walk under ladders. You gotta be quirky, and then there's you and all your stuff. And so I've decided that I should start believing in and collecting crystals with metaphysical properties. So this is a good one. This is an amethyst, I think, and it's like gives you more creative energy. And you bury it in the garden so that it is powered by the earth, and then you dig it up and you just like manifest. Try it, Joe. And then these ones. And then I really believe in this. And I like carry them when I fly, and I'm just like,
you can fly, that's fucking amazing.
This one's a quartz. That's for unconditional love. That's what I have for you. And also faith in you as a leader. And then this one is just like for purity. And this is the sea. I don't know why, just so you can swim better. And so I brought them here today to help us win.
Are you getting enough sleep?
No.
Okay. John, have you got a mascot?
Well, yes, I have, Jimmy. This week I've brought a mascot that I hope to monetize.
Ooh,
and this is not just my mascot, this is now the official Countdown mascot, because to my knowledge you don't have one. So this is now the official Countdown mascot. This is Clocky. He's got a full backstory, Clocky. Born in the 60s. So not into drugs himself, but his parents did a lot. As a result, not really looked after, but managed to get himself to a university and went to Clocksford. And then Countdown happened in 1983, and suddenly everybody wanted a 30-second clock. And now you can take Clocky around with you. So if you buy your own Clocky, it's got a little pad here. This is the clock socket. And you can attach Clocky to whatever you like, and it's just good for at any point you want 30 seconds to go by. So if someone rings and you don't really want to talk to them, you just start Clocky and that noise on the phone gives a certain sort of pressure to whoever you're talking to. Yeah, yeah, I've got about 30 seconds. Bang. Bye.
So what else do you use it for, John?
You could do 30-second workouts.
30-second workouts?
Quite a big thing now, isn't it, this, what do they call it, high-intensity HIIT training. They say do 20 minutes. I say 30 seconds.
can we see 30 seconds of training?
You do, like, 30 seconds of push-ups, something like that, so obviously
I'd... Well, what would you do?
I'd do 30 seconds of push-ups. I do that every day.
Yeah, go on.
I just don't think I need to. I just think it's so clear. You can do 30 seconds of, like, step-ups.
Ladies and gentlemen, I think we'd want to see 30 seconds of training.
Oh. Careful,
I think you've just broken that.
I think it might be a design flaw. Fucking
hell. Sorry, did you just blow...
Just blowing the clock, sucker!
Come on, John, come on, we're looking forward to this.
I don't know why I've even got into this position.
Ready?
Yeah.
You start and I'll press.
You press and I'll start. There
we go.
You can do it, John.
Go ahead.
That's one.
Keep going, John.
Come on, two.
Keep going, John. Oh. Do it for Glocky.
Three.
Come on.
Four.
Five.
About 50, was it, I think?
OK. Joe, do you have a mascot?
Yeah, I do, but it's a little bit embarrassing, my one. It's, I basically, when I was little, I had a doll. And I loved that doll, and I took it everywhere with me. So, basically, I brought my doll along. Doll I had as a kid. Yeah, this is the doll I had when I was a toddler. her name's Tiffany. And yeah, we went everywhere together.
Is that not a sex doll?
What's wrong with you? No. You're a pervert, mate. It's a kid's doll. Right, John, hold that, right?
I don't really want to touch it, to be honest.
She's just a little doll, mate. You think
you had that when you were a child?
Yeah, and I got it as a christening present.
Oh, it's squidgy, it's squidgy. Feel it.
It's a lovely dolly. Basically, it's just a normal doll that every kid had. I prove it to you, look, this is us. This is us at the... this is us at the fun fair. this is us. This is us at football training. I can't believe you think it's a sex doll. It's just perfectly normal doll that used to...
Who gave you the doll, Joe?
My Uncle Terry for a christening present. He had a load in the van.
She can make a fist.
Yeah, she can, yeah. It can go up your arse as well. There's what you have.
OK, over the dictionary corner, we've got David O'Doherty. David has that just-got-out-of-bed look if the bed was some flattened cardboard boxes in the doorway of a Curry's Digital.
You look like Dracula's less successful younger brother.
Countdown. David, if you died today, what would be your greatest achievement?
I mean, a lot of people talk about it, but I actually did the old popcorn trick a few years ago. What? In the cinema, the popcorn, and you have it on your lap, and you just, you know, you...
With the...
up through the. I actually did. I'm the one person who actually did it.
Wow.
The movie choice was wrong. Philomena is. it's an amazing film, but and the other problem is I've been led to believe it would be instant hilarity, but the two things that I hadn't factored in were, one is the size of a contemporary cinema popcorn box, so it's like a giant waste paper basket, and secondly, how salted popcorn is. I think I basically pickled it. I think it's possible hundreds of years after I'm dead, my wanger will still be perfectly preserved. I think it was like a Viking's purse or something like that.
Susie, were you surprised when you got to the bottom?
OK. And with David, of course, it's Susie Dent.
Yeah. In David's most recent book, he named a squirrel after Susie Dent. Small, wild and with an insatiable appetite for nuts, Susie was delighted.
I was really happy when he told me I was a character in his book. And then the squirrel bit came and I thought, well, OK. But apparently I'm a thief. And a credit card thief.
Well, yeah, Susie helps me with... I write children's books, and Susie knows the correct way to spell meow and words like that. And then, to thank her, I made her into a criminal squirrel in the new book. Yeah, that's... Aww. That's the time she met Joe.
OK, and in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel loves her food, and for a treat, she often eats gluten-free, organic, vegan cupcakes. That's a coincidence, Rachel, because sometimes, as a treat, I don't. Rachel, what's your worst habit?
I guess food. Like you said, there's a lot of stuff I can't eat, so sometimes it's just finding whatever's in the cupboard I can eat. So the other day I had just nachos for starters and thought I'd do a bit of cooking for main, so I had toast. The worst one I ever made was gluten-free pasta with Doritos dip. Rank, absolutely.
Joe, what's your worst habit?
Following people around, I suppose.
OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Metal Detector. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for our first game. John and Chris, you get to pick the letters.
Please.
Oh, can I? Brilliant. Please, can I have a vowel?
You can. Thank you, Chris.
Southpaw.
Two vowels, three consonants.
O.
And four from anywhere else, please.
G. L. R.
Consonant.
F.
Vowel.
I.
Oh, God. Consonant and vowel.
P. And... E.
And for the first time today, here's the countdown clock.
One, two, three, four, I declare a thumb war.
All right.
One, two, three, four, I declare a thumb war.
Yeah, fuck you, lady. Chris, how many?
Seven.
Oh, John, how many?
Eight.
Joe, how many?
Five-ish.
Five-ish. And Catherine?
Six. Six. Not okay, seven or eight.
No. Joe, you're five.
Lager.
Catherine, you're six.
Goalie.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. Oh. Chris, you're seven.
Fragile.
Huge. John, you're eight.
It's another word for a lady's night aid. A frig pole.
Yeah, a frig pole.
No frig pole.
7 points to Chris. Good, good start. It's a good start. David, Susie, could they have done any better?
We got a cup, and by we, I mean one of us more than the other, got a couple of other sevens. Profile, pergola, 1-8, though. Leapfrog.
Oh,
yeah. Like, sorry, leapfrog. Guys.
So at the end of that, John and Chris are in the lead with 7. On to our first numbers round, OK? Joe, Katherine, you get to pick the numbers.
I don't know what's going on. You do it.
We just have to decide how many big numbers we want and how many small we want.
Okay, look, I feel sick when I'm this year. I find this one really odd.
Has anyone ever got no biggies? Can you get all littlies?
Yeah.
Is that, I mean, because that would be, if you're just trying to ruin them, that might be enough.
David, what the hell, man? We've known each other for years.
Let's have 100, because that's always easy.
Yeah.
And then some little ones.
You can't actually pick the numbers. She's rubbing a crystal on his head. Let's go with 6 small and press the buttons.
You manifest and say what number you want it to be, and I bet it will be it.
2.
OK, what's she going to say next?
4.
4.
And then?
I cut 1.
Yeah. What do you think next?
It's a small picture of a pony.
Okay, Joe.
Go on, guess the target,
2, 4,
though.
Oh, I'll guess the target. Hold on.
2 and 4.
Guess the target, come on.
723. Bang odds.
Ooh!
So
close. That was freaky.
OK, and your time starts now.
You can't do it. How the hell? We need a big one. Even a 25. Oh, this might make me feel sick. I just can't do that. Okay, that was a really bad idea.
So the target was 315. Joe, did you get it?
I got 4.
Could you talk us through your working?
I just wrote 4 in the corner.
Okay, so you wrote 4. Yeah. What did you get, Katherine?
I got 280.
280? Wow.
That's excellent.
Chris, did you get it?
I got 230.
Woo! I'm smarter than Chris Addison.
Okay, John, did you get it?
No, I didn't. But I sort of think...
Well, John, bear in mind, this is...
I got a sum, but I just didn't get any of the numbers in the sum.
I basically multiplied everything together except the one which I added to try and...
I popped a 4 in the corner.
If you show that to Jimmy, he's not going to say it's a 4.
Chris and John, I've got the same amount of points as you, and I just wrote a 4 in the corner.
OK, Rachel, it was easy. How did you do it?
It was impossible, actually.
Yes!
You could have got some points, but you couldn't have got 315.
OK, so the scores at the moment, Joe and Katherine have no points. John and Chris have 7. And here is your teaser. The words are a bell end. The clue is, you can have it, but I'll need it back. That's a bell end. You can have it, but I'll need it back. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were a bell end. The clue was, you can have it, but I'll need it back. It was, of course, lendable. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Joe and Chris. So, Joe, your turn to choose the letters. Chris, your turn to win.
I'll have a consonant, please.
Thank you, Joe. S.
Oh, yeah, could be plural. I'll have a T, then it could be, like, stops.
It's not. Thank you.
Whenever you hold the crystal, you look like Rasputin.
Let's put some of them in you, like in your pocket.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Pop an O up.
Nice.
Ooh. Ooh, all right, a P. Ooh, an L P. I've got one down. Shite. consonant, please.
G.
I need more of the other ones.
Yep.
Vowels.
Oh.
And then I'll have another. Go on, another vowel.
I.
Oh, an N. I mean, consonant.
OK, and your time starts now.
Oh, I think I'm just going to stretch this out. I think I've done my hamstring. Shit. Joe, what'd you get? How many?
Can you ask Chris first?
Chris, how many?
I got one more than Joe.
So, Joe, how many did you get?
Do you reckon that's a word?
Thanks, mate.
I've got a five.
Yeah, Chris, what have you got?
I have actually got a five.
Yes!
Whoa! We're in it! Oh. Chris, what was your five?
Swigs or twigs.
Joe, your five?
Moist.
Ooh.
Oh, that's really good, isn't it? I was going to go moists, plural.
Because he gets all the babes
yeah,
wet.
Yeah.
Susie Dent. Am I right in saying that your least favourite word in the English language is moist?
Yes. Could it be plural?
Well, it can't be plural, but these days you can put an S on it as a verb.
What oh, shit the bed!
What does it mean, then, moist? She moists the...
You like the word gusset?
Look! You went to Dictionary Corner!
What about the word squelch?
I like squelch.
You like squelch?
Squelch is all right.
I think we've lost focus.
OK, 5 points to both teams. Could they have done any better in Dictionary Corner?
No, six was top, really.
OK, so at the end of that, Joe and Katherine have 5 points, which they're very pleased about. John and Chris have 12. Right. Now time for John and Katherine to go head-to-head. John, your turn to pick the numbers.
Bung a big one up, trust me. Bollocking on.
Bung a big one up, please, Rachel.
The one.
And then what's the verb for the smaller ones?
A couple of titchy ones.
A couple of titchy ones.
Four.
And then go for your life,
seven.
Love.
And then go for your life, love.
All right, don't piss about. Put the little one.
And eight.
There you go.
And target.
Oh, I don't know if I
should. Shall we?
Yeah. No, don't you dare, you.
Okay, your time starts now.
Oh, no. No, I don't know how to do that.
So, Katherine, did you get it?
No, I got 771.
Oh, that's amazing.
Oh, OK. Pretty good, though. John, did you get it?
I got 769.
Oh, that's the same.
Katherine, how did you get 771?
8 times 100 is 800.
Yep.
Lovely stuff.
7 times 4 is 28, plus 1 is 29. Subtract that from 800, and you get 771.
7 points to Katherine. How did you get 769?
This is going to get very exciting for Joe because I actually got 779.
Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! 7 points for Katherine.
It's maybe going with it.
It's the crystals, you think?
Oh, yeah, you put one up your bum, magic happens.
You believe in the universe.
Yeah.
You can make amazing things happen.
I believe in the universe.
Explain how we're winning. Are we winning?
No. Rachel, 770 looked pretty easy to me. Could it be done?
Yeah, there were a couple of ways.
Oh, of course there are.
Sorry, Joe. Could have said 100 plus 4, 104, times 7, 728, minus the 8, and add the 50.
Yeah.
OK, so Joe and Katherine have 12. John and Chris also have 12. It's all level. OK, time now to go over to Dictionary Corner. David O'Doherty, what have you got for us?
Well, I've got the party machine, everyone, and this is a song about communication. My friend was in a restaurant on a date and the date was going really badly. The guy was the most boring and stupid guy he'd ever been on a date with. He was wondering why he'd gone on a date with such a boring and stupid guy. Just then the boring and stupid guy got up and went to the loo. And my friend decided to send a text message to another one of our friends outlining the ways in which the guy was both boring and stupid and including in it some direct quotes of things that he'd said that were boring and stupid. When the boring and stupid guy came back from the loo, he could barely talk and he'd obviously just been crying. And my friend realised that he'd sent a text to the person the text was about. Yes, he'd sent a text to the person the text was about. You could try and pretend there was just a joke. That you were just being rude in an over-the-top, inappropriately joking way. But you can never be sure if the person believes you, so your relationship's effectively ruined anyway. You can just be honest and apologize, but now they know what you actually think about them. The best thing you can do is just delete their details from your phone and hope you never, ever, ever, ever see them again. A while ago, I did this song for the first time ever. I was on my way home on my bike having tried out the song and I felt a text message in my pocket, so I pulled over my bike to see who it was from, and it was from a friend of mine who'd been at the gig, and the text message said, that was the worst gig I've ever seen him do. He used to be funny, but he's really lost it lately. Complete bullshit. Even though he phoned up a minute later and we had a good laugh about what a hilarious prank he'd play, I still can't be sure. He didn't send a text to the person the text was about.
David, he's up here, everyone. And here is your teaser. The words are suck pits. The clue is put your hands above your head. That's suck pits. Put your hands above your head. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were suck pits. The clue was put your hands above your head. It was, of course, stick-ups. Before we go on, a chance for our teams to win some bonus points. I've got a selection of objects, all spelt with 9 letters. All they have to do is identify them with their hands whilst wearing a blindfold. Mm. Whoever identifies the most objects gets the points. Jon and Joe, you're playing this, so join me at the feeling station.
Thank you. Cheers, mate.
There you go.
Thanks, mate.
Joe, you're just over there on that little mark.
Sorry,
there.
Mate.
Oh, it's going to be like that, is it?
Yeah.
OK. So you're against the clock. All you've got to do is identify the 9-letter objects. First person who guesses correctly wins the point. Your time starts now. First item, please.
What the hell is it?
Oh, it's going to be between the two of you. OK, there it is.
Hello.
There you go.
Brazier?
Brazier is the right one. Oh, no, OK, next one. Gotta be quick. Okay, there you go. Be gentle, be gentle, be gentle.
Oh, it's a dog.
Let me just check with Susie. Is that a 9-letter word? It is not. 3 letters.
Sausage dog.
Is it a sausage dog?
It is a sausage dog, yeah.
But what dog with 6 G's?
Dachshund.
Yes, that's right.
Oh, come on. Great.
Don't worry, thank you. John's gone to live at the farm now. OK, guys? What, kind of that way? In there? There you go.
Oh, oh. Christ!
Oh. You have to go lower down, lower down. Not there. Lower, 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 lower. There you go.
Oh, stockings.
Correct.
Yes!
OK, go lower. Lower, lower. There you go, round there. Lower, Joe. Joe, a bit lower. What do you think that could be?
Cock and balls!
No, it's not cock and balls,
no. Strap on?
Sausage!
It's a kind of sausage.
Frankfurter.
Small sausage is called...
Chipolata!
Chipolata is the right answer, yeah. Okay.
It is,
Come on, Joe.
Hey, hey, hey!
Let's see if Joe recognises his own father.
Scientist?
He's not a scientist.
Fisherman.
Yes!
Yes, oh. Great answer.
What's happening?
John, you got the most right. That means you get five bonus points. Come on. That's it. OK, on with the game. John, Chris, your turn to choose the letters.
Sorry, Catherine.
Consonant, please.
Thank you, John.
Strong sound.
H.
And a vowel.
A.
A consonant, please.
T.
Yes! I'm out.
Consonant, please.
S.
Should have declared yourself out too early, mate. You just lost the round.
Shat.
A vowel, please.
E.
A vowel, please.
I.
A consonant, please.
K.
And a consonant, please.
Don't lose confidence.
And a final consonant, I guess.
And a final N.
OK, and your time starts now. How many?
Four.
OK, Catherine, how many?
Six.
Oh, six.
Magic stuff.
Yeah. Chris, how many?
Six.
Oh, we're still in it.
John?
Eight.
Oh, hello.
Is it risky, eight?
I would put your mortgage on it.
Joe?
I've got a couple. I've got hats and I've got shat.
Hi, Catherine, you're six.
Thanks.
Oh, smashing stuff.
Chris? Shiter. More shite.
Shiter?
Yes.
Is shiter in there, Susie?
I'm sorry.
Oh, I'm sorry. Do you two maybe need some popcorn? Is shiter in there?
Shiter's not in there, I'm afraid, Chris.
OK. John, you're eight.
Thinkers.
Amazing.
Hey. Oh!
Thinkers.
Yeah. Yeah. Very good.
OK, David, Susie, could they have done any better?
Thinkers is as good as we're going to get. Yeah. An eight.
OK, nice 8 points to John and Chris. So, at the end of that, John and Chris are in the lead with 25 points. Time to go across the dictionary corner once again. David, what have you got for us?
Well, I've made a mistake in the past of sometimes looking at Twitter while the show is on, and a lot of things are said about Dictionary Corner. One of the criticisms is that, Susie, that we don't like to party, and that is so wrong right here. I'm going to give you... Susie, what's the time? It's party time, correct. Because there's a party starting right now. You are all invited. Party starting right now. Time to get excited. If the neighbors who live on this side have gone away, and the neighbors who live on this side are old and pretty much deaf. Party, 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 party. There's gonna be lots of ladies and men at our party with some cheese in the kitchen. Baby bells, there'll be streamers flying through the air. Someone will probably go home wearing someone else's coat. It's gonna be fucking mayhem! Tell all your friends and invite them along, but not friends of friends. That would be too many friends. And this party needs some basic ground rules. You don't want a situation like at Rob's party last year, where a CD went missing, someone broke a chair.
Someone tried to fill Rob's dog with helium. Tried to stick him up onto the ceilium. But he didn't float up or bark high-pitched. He just became violently ill. Party, 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 party! Someone's drinking beer from a shoe with a crazy straw. When the party starts to rock, don't use the downstairs loop because it gets blocked. Woo, we're gonna party on through till the break of dawn, or until I come down in my dressing gown and say, that's it, everyone, party over. I need to go, I'm up early in the morning, can you please take your coats off my bed? Some of the sleeping goats, there's two people, the goats, people are doing it in the coats! Second coat party, second coat party, second coat party.
David, you're docking everyone. And here is your final teaser. The words are, let's pump. The clue is, it's big and juicy. That's let's pump, it's big and juicy. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were, let's pump. The clue was, it's big and juicy. It was, of course, plumpest. OK, time for our final letters game. Joe and Katherine, you get to choose the letters.
Do this, Joe.
Comes round quick, doesn't it?
Yeah. We have consonant, please, Rachel. Thank you, Katherine. V.
Oh.
Another consonant,
no,
please.
No,
there's
no... V. Spells vowel of...
Yeah!
Another consonant, please. You think?
M.
Vowel.
E.
Yep. Another, please.
U.
Another vowel.
A.
And the rest, consonants? What do you think?
Oh, I have no idea.
R. And T.
OK, and your time starts...
now.
Oh, shit. His head's gone.
Joe, what have you got? How many?
It's irrelevant. Five.
Katherine?
I've only got six.
Chris?
Yeah, six.
Six. Oh, and John?
Six. Three.
Well, let's hear your three, John.
Gum.
OK, gum. So what was your five, Joe?
Great.
OK, Katherine, what was your six?
Mine was grated, but like cheese.
Yeah, I should have popped a D on the end.
Well, they're back. Chris, you're six?
Yeah, mine is grated with.
Hey.
Oh, that's coincidence.
Okay, 6 points to both teams.
Ah.
David, Susan, could they have done any better?
Seven was the best with matured.
OK, so Joe and Katherine have 18, John and Chris have 31.
Oh.
I think it's 31.
So we're still in it to win it?
No.
Why not?
Because you are too far behind. You cannot win.
Why are you being a prick?
OK, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Your time starts now.
What exactly do we have to do?
You have to guess what the word is. It's jumbled up. John.
Oh, I've got it. I thought it was tinchiest.
It's not tinchiest.
Not even close. Man.
As in, he is the tinchiest strider I've ever seen.
Okay, smallest of the striders. OK, let's try again.
Chestnuts!
It's, I'll just check, it's not chestnuts. I'll start the clock again. Chris.
Itchiness.
Itchiness is the... Well, let's have a look.
Oh, yeah, is it? Wonderful.
So, the final scores are Joe and Katherine have 18 points, but tonight's winners with 41, Jon and Chris. Congratulations, you're now the proud owners of this The Countdown Metal Detector. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Burning a hole in the pockets of four new young millionaires, Nick Helm stars in our brand new comedy Loaded, starting next Monday at 10. And starting this Friday, a right good ribbing at Kay Van Novak with fake news and pranks in brand new Britain Today, tonight at 10. Next, stand by for stand-up comedy with Alan Carr.